Welcome back here to Fox and Friends on this beautiful sunny afternoon. And of course, you can get a little bit of a burn if you've got a little bit of a bald spot this afternoon.
Yeah, you got a sunscreen up the dome.
Yeah. We're here this morning with Dr. Robert Bernstein. He's a clinical professor of dermatology at Columbia University. And to talk about baldness and some cures and some ways to fix this problem if you're a little thin on top. Right, Doc?
Right.
Well, welcome. And all right, let's start out here. What are we going to start with? We're going to start with some of the medical procedures that you might be able to get that aren't on the table, some procedures, right?
Yeah, a hair transplant. Tell us about what's involved in that.
For extensive hair loss, we use a transplant. And the gold standard is a procedure called follicular unit hair transplantation. And in that procedure, we take a strip from the back of the scalp, and then that strip is put under a series of microscopes.
Okay.
And hair follicles are dissected out in little tiny groups of 1 to 4 hairs and then placed into the top of the scalp.
Okay, we have a before picture, I believe.
Show you a before
what
after.
This looks like.
Okay, this is before the transplant, and then let's see after.
Yeah, let's see what this looks like after, and this is after the actual hair transplant being pulled from the back of the hair.
Right.
That's incredibly effective.
So hair plugs are a thing of the past now, is that right?
Right. Hair plugs went out about 20 years ago, but unfortunately many people...
I don't know if people know that, because I have some friends that have them.
And I didn't realize it based on that photo that Kevin Spacey had hair plugs. All right, let's move to the next step.
All right, some of the medications you can take, obviously one you hear the most about is Propecia. How effective is this one?
Propecia is the most effective medication. It works about 85% of the time. But it works best in preserving hair. It'll grow back hair, a significant amount of hair, in only a small percentage of patients, perhaps 25.
Is it like Rogaine? I know Rogaine's preventative, right? You want to do this when you're younger?
Right. They're both preventative.
Okay.
But in growing hair back, Propecia will be much more effective than Rogaine.
All right.
Okay, now this looks like something that I might use on a dog.
On a dog, right.
But this is the Hair Max comb.
Right.
What in the world does this do?
Okay, well, this is actually low-level light therapy. It started being used, delivered in like a hairdresser's helmet. But what the laser comb does is it separates the hair, so it allows the light beam to penetrate the scalp. It works a tiny bit. There's only been really one good study showing that it works, and the results have not been really looked at long term.
Give it a shot. Do you feel it working?
I feel it working already.
All
I'm
right,
feeling
Doc,
something.
Surprising new study that I read about a couple of weeks ago that Botox can actually be used to treat baldness. How in the world does that work?
Right. Well, what was interesting is that the patients that were looked at had chemotherapy, and hair grows back after chemotherapy naturally. So this really has to be looked at a little bit more carefully.
Yeah.
The hypothesis was that it stimulates blood flow. But genetic hair loss is not related to blood flow. It was also hypothesized that it relaxed muscles. We know, genetic balding is not related to muscles. There are no muscles on the scalp. So we really have to look at this a little bit more carefully.
Dr. Robert Bernstein, stick around for the After the Show. We're going to talk more about this coming up in just a bit. But first, we're going to go to the New York Aquarium for a last...